exclusive report tonight about the State Department's push to build a new embassy in an area of Beirut, Lebanon, that is controlled by the same people who are blamed for two U.S. embassy bombings. Embassy security is a sensitive issue for the United States all around the world, nowhere more so than in Beirut. So why would the government want to put a new embassy there in an area controlled by a group it considers a terrorist organization? Brian Ross has the story.
The proposed new embassy site is just a few hundred yards from the scene of fierce fighting last summer between Hezbollah and Israeli forces. No place for Americans, according to a former top Lebanese general.
I do not think that piece of land is secure.
Lebanese and U.S. officials say the site, purchased by the U.S. 2 years ago for more than $22 million, would be a dangerous place for Americans even during times of relative peace because of Hezbollah's control of the area.
It boggles my mind. Any reasonable person that looks at that site, does their homework, and see who controls that area would determine that it's a foolish, dangerous idea to build the embassy there.
Twice in the 1980s, Hezbollah was blamed for deadly truck bomb attacks on the U.S. embassy and a U.S. embassy annex in Beirut, killing 87 people, including 8 CIA employees. Lebanese officials are stunned the U.S. would now move into actual Hezbollah territory.
I do not advise them to move to this location.
But the strongest opposition and outrage came from the U.S. ambassador in Beirut. In a May 31st cable about growing security concerns, Ambassador Jeffrey Feltman told Secretary of State Rice his staff unanimously opposes construction because Hezbollah has the strength in this area, not the government of Lebanon. The ambassador said his local staff will refuse to work where they will be an easy target, and U.S. diplomats would be under siege during any conflict.
Anytime Hezbollah wants to shut the place down, they're capable of doing it. And the loss of life would be tremendous.
The project appeared to have a green light until late today, just 2 days after we began to make inquiries at the State Department, and after months of ignoring its own ambassador. The State Department announced to ABC News just a few hours ago that the project had been postponed indefinitely, meaning it's been killed. Officials said Secretary Rice made the decision earlier this month. But no one, including the ambassador in Beirut and the people building the embassy, had been told about that until officials responded to inquiries today from ABC.
Men say they told me so, but it doesn't matter. It was plain to see that a small town boy like me just wasn't your cup of tea. I was wishful thinking. I gave you my heart, and I tried to make you happy.